in 2006, in February 2006, Hackney Council planned to start the demolishing of the building. And just a few days before the demolishing was supposed to start, the preparation was supposed to start, a handful of people, which called themselves Everything for Everyone, occupied the building. And although Hackney Council tried lots of dirty tricks to evict them, first illegally by the builders, then took them to High Court, the High Court refused to evict the people. It took them 8 months to get rid of the squatters in this building. And they were finally evicted in November 2006. And then a few months later, the demolishing started.
That's exactly how the stuff is.
Put one next to the other.
Anybody not got one of these?
You got one.
There you go. Thank you.
Hi, I've had the music shop over there for about 35 years now. 2002, we were offered, we were told they were selling all the shops, and they were up for individual, and we were told we had to go to the auction to buy them. I asked, why do I have to go to auction to buy this shop? And they said, it's up, you'll be able to buy your shop, it's just that we need the money, we want to make sure we got the right money. When we got to auction, they changed and sold them all as a lot, not giving us any chance at all. Since then, we've had, 6 years of hell. If you see, we've had about 4 or 5 arson attacks, and this lot has been left to rot like this. Now, the council have been told to compulsory purchase back, and they've been dragging their heels, and now it's come up that they make compulsory purchase back. This year they can't negotiate, but it's gone now 6 years. And the bakers, 45 years, he was thrown out. The caterers, they've wrecked the whole lot of businesses along here.
That's why it looks so bad. And yet this was years ago, this was a thriving community here.
Now in Holly Street, and this area was called, or is called, Holly Street Estate, or now it's called Queensbridge Quarter. That's the new name for the development here. And historically, in the first part of the 19th century, this area was completely free here. There was no connection between central London and Dalston and Hackney. There was only Dalston Lane. And this changed dramatically when the railway was built to Dalston Lane. Then this whole area became home for the working class of central London, and they built all these terraced houses which now look pretty, pretty nice. In the Second World War, this side of Queensbridge Road was heavily damaged by bombing, so it was lots of space to build these kind of estates later on in the 60s and 70s. Now, since the 90s, they started to demolish the estates, and as usual in London, the estates were replaced by much fewer living units, by much fewer flats. For example, the estate we see here on this side, originally there were 1,400 flats in this area, which are now 500, and the starting cost for two bedroom flat is £350,000 to £500,000.
Well, I work in an old century East London, and just a couple of stories. I had another client who is in a wheelchair, and he needs to get out of his flat to get out completely. He has to use the communal There's a special lift for him using the communal electricity. And I think it was Swan Housing Association was his landlord. And when it came to paying the electricity bills for the communal areas in the blocks, they paid for the private ones first. They didn't have enough money to pay for the other ones. And so for 2 weeks, he couldn't get out of his flat because they hadn't paid the bill. And I think just the illustration is that in these mixed tenure blocks, it's really, really clear who comes first and who's second class, and people know it. And it is not the dream that New Labour says it is. Right behind us, number 59 of Maple Dean Road was bought by a young couple, Tony Blair and Sherry Booth, in 1980. And their first house for a mere £40,000. I guess what we're trying to say is by going on this journey is looking at the progression from these sort of terraced houses being built as homes for the working class, being shared by several families, being quite overcrowded, and that progression into council-built housing, which is now more under attack, and the different levels of change that there have been in this area. So, yeah, which you'll notice around you as we carry on our walk.
Okay. This is Baton Court. It's well, it was sheltered accommodation for the elderly. There are some elderly people who've been placed here temporarily, who may well be trying to get some kit. Hackney Council stock transferred its sheltered accommodation in 2002 to a housing association called Hanover in Hackney. And what they want to do here, what they've got planning permission to do here, is to build 14 private houses for sale. There's a dispute over the planning permission because it wasn't advertised properly, so people didn't have an opportunity to object. So that's in dispute at the moment. But this is actually common land, which is why, apart from the shabby treatment of elderly people, this is why local people are very pissed off.